गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। माय पेपर टाइटल इज कैरेक्टराइजेशन ऑफ सिस्टिक इंट्राक्रेनियल ब्रेन लीजन्स यूजिंग डिफ्यूजन टेंसर इमेजिंग मैट्रिक्स। बैकग्राउंड, सिस्टिक इंट्राक्रेनियल लीजन्स आर कॉमन फाइंडिंग्स इन एमआर इमेजिंग। द डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस रेंजिंग फ्रॉम सिंपल अरेक्नॉइड सिस्ट टू हाई ग्रेड ट्यूमर्स विद सिस्टिक कंपोनेंट, वेयर द मैनेजमेंट ग्रोसली डिफर्स फ्रॉम सिस्ट विच रिक्वायर्स नो ट्रीटमेंट टू सर्जरी। Intracranial cyst can be divided into non-neoplastic and neoplastic lesions, and this differentiation of intracranial cystic lesions is sometimes difficult by conventional MR imaging alone. So, such conventional scans are not sensitive to microstructural architecture of tissue. But DTI, it is an advanced MRI sequence based on diffusion-weighted imaging that non-invasively displays the pathophysiological changes of altered brain structures. In brain tissue, water can not move freely in all directions as surrounding tissue structures limit its movement and hence shows preferential movement along certain directions. Likewise, it is easier for water to diffuse along the course of a white matter fiber rather than perpendicular to it, as external membranes and myelin sheath act as a barrier to the movement of water molecules. This property of preferential movement is diffusion anisotropy. The DTI technique basically capture mean diffusivity and fractional anisotropy by placing the cursor on the ROI. Aims, characterization of intracranial cystic lesions using diffusion tensor imaging matrix. Total sample size taken is 15. Now cases. First is epidermoid cyst. In this, an ill-defined, irregular, lobulated extra-axial cystic lesion is seen in the right cerebellopontine angle, appearing hypo-intense on T1, hyper-intense on T2, with partial suppression on FLAIR images, causing mass effect on pons and cerebral peduncle and showing diffusion restriction on the DWI and thin peripheral rim of enhancement on post-contrast scan. In this, the FA value fractional anisotropy is highest, that is 327. Now second is dermoid cyst. In this, a well-marginated extra-axial fat-containing midline lesion is seen in the anterior interhemispheric fissure, appearing T1 heterogeneous signal with few hyperintense areas showing signal suppression on fat set images and T2 hyperintense and diffusion restriction on DWI and no post contrast enhancement is seen. In this also FA is 157 and because of the heterogeneous content in the dermoid cyst. Now third is arachnoid cyst. In this a well-defined extra-axial, well-defined round lesion seen in the retrocerebellar location posterior to the right cerebellar hemisphere, showing CSF attenuation on all sequences and no diffusion restriction is seen on DWI. Here ADC value is highest because it is water, CSF density. So movement of water molecules is easy. Now fourth is colloid cyst. In this, a well-defined round lesion is seen at the foramen of Monroe, appearing iso-intense on T1, T2 and hyper-intense on FLAIR. Here FA value is around 150 due to the increased mucin content, so FA value is highest, is little less than the epidermoid cyst. Now fifth is racemos neurocysticercosis. In this, multiple well-defined intercommunicating cystic T1 hypo-intense, T2 hyper-intense lesions seen along the interhemispheric fissure showing complete suppression on FLAIR images and few vessels of A2 segment are seen traversing through the cystic space and no abnormal post-contrast enhancement is seen. Sixth is vestibular schwannoma. In this, a large lobulated extra-axial mass of size 4 into 3 into 2 cm noted in the left cerebellopontine cistern with intercanalicular extension in left internal acoustic canal via porous acousticus. The lesion is hypo-intense on T1, heterogeneously hyper-intense on T2 and few areas suppressed on FLAIR, suggestive of cystic changes. Few areas in the mass appears bright on DWI and dark on ADC, suggestive of restriction. Blooming foci are also seen in the mass. Now seventh is pilocytic astrocytoma. It is a heterogeneously enhancing T2 hyper-intense lesion seen in the anterior parafalcine right frontal region with mild perifocal edema. On post-contrast lesions, shows non-enhancing cystic necrotic area and enhancing solid component. ADC value is higher in this because of the CSF nature. Now, choroid plexus cyst. In this, a multilobulated cystic lesion noted within the body of lateral ventricle causing moderate dilatation and irregular ependymal lining of lateral ventricles. The lesion shows CSF signal or on sequences, choroid plexus not visualized separately within the lateral ventricle, and marked thinning of the corpus callosum is seen. Now next is abscess. An area of altered signal intensity is noted in the left medial temporal lobe adjacent to the left cavernous sinus, appearing hypo to iso on T2 flare with smooth peripheral post-contrast enhancement. And in abscess, ADC value is low. Tuberculoma, there are few irregular variable size conglomerated peripherally enhancing lesions seen, largest of size 16 to 13 mm seen in the right cerebellar hemisphere, appearing T1, T2 hypointense with surrounding perilesional edema. No diffusion restriction is seen on the DWI. Central neurocytoma, a well-defined cystic lesion located in the body of right lateral ventricle causing its expansion and shifting the septum pallidum to the left. On SWI images, it shows blooming with hyperintense signal on phase sensitive hemorrhage. The solid areas of lesion shows diffusion restriction. On post-contrast, the lesion shows nodular enhancement with enhancing septa with non-enhancing necrotic area within. Next is cystic pituitary macroadenoma. It is a well-marginated lesion, cellar mass with supracellular extent. It is a well-marginated lesion seen in the cella and appearing homogeneously hyperintense on T2 flare with non-visualization of anterior pituitary separately. And the lesion enhances peripherally on post-contrast scan. Now, anaplastic oligodendroglioma, it is a well-delineated peripherally cortical-based interaxial mass that is seen in right parieto-temporal region involving cortex and subcortical white matter. It appears hypo-intense on T1, hyper-intense on T2, iso-hype to hyper-intense on flare with few areas of blooming on SWI, sensitive hemorrhage. It shows patchy areas of restriction and shows post-contrast heterogeneous enhancement with non-enhancing area sensitive of necrosis. Now, craniopharyngioma, it is a multilobulated solid cystic mass noted predominantly in the supracellular region, and it is the cystic component of the mass is hyperintense on T1 and T2 and not completely suppressed on flare. Solid component of the mass is isointense on T1 and hypointense on T2. Blooming foci are seen peripherally around the lesion on SWI, sensitive of calcification. No evidence of diffusion restriction is seen, and on post-contrast scan, the mass is showing peripheral enhancement and MRS shows large lactate peak. Hemangioblastoma, it is a well-defined, predominantly cystic lesion with enhancing mural nodule seen in the right cerebellar hemisphere with mass effect as described. Now, results are, the studies revealed that fractional anisotropy and mean diffusivity values helps in differentiating various cystic brain lesions. And epidermoid cysts found to have increased FA value, but ADC value is similar to that of the normal white matter. So basically, FA is increased because of the creatine content, which leads to compact internal architecture. Now, neurocystic sarcosis showed high FA next to epidermoid cyst, and DTI helpful in characterizing various stages of NCC. Brain abscess showed decreased ADC values, while cystic tumor showed increased ADC and low FA values. Brain abscess showed decreased diffusion due to the inflammatory cells and debris within, while tumor cyst showed increased diffusivity due to clear fluid and less inflammatory cells. Arachnoid cyst, choroid plexus cyst showed high ADC values and low FA value because of the CSF nature and less hindrance to the water molecules. Low-grade tumor cyst showed decreased FA and high ADC values, and high-grade tumor cyst showed increased FA and decreased ADC due to more cellular component. Tuberculoma showed decreased ADC values, and dermoid cyst and colloid cyst showed increased FA. The ADC values were found to be higher than that of the normal brain parenchyma, but less than that of the CSF. The viscous nature of the content inside the colloid cyst leads to increased diffusion. Hence, diffusion tensor imaging derived metrics helpful in distinguishing cystic brain lesions. Conclusion: DTI with calculated FAMD values, that is ADC values, add more information to the MRI in differentiation of cystic brain lesions and help in therapeutic decision making and eventually patient outcome. Thank you.